Hello everyone. This video is going to be about transformations. But first, let's just left click and drag across these and delete them, because we don't need them, they're just a nuisance at this point. I'll press X to delete. Now you could also press the delete key, but it's on the right side of the keyboard. And I'll just stick to the left side of the keyboard, and X is also for deleting things. Now let's get on with transformations. If I hover across these three buttons, it says move, rotate and scale. So let's just start with move and select the cube. Now you can see arrows. If I just left click the red arrow, for instance, and drag, I'm moving the cube across X. And in the top left you can see how much. So now I'm holding down control and I'm moving in steps. In this case, steps of 1 meter, but the unit is not that important, you can change it. So holding down control shift, it's moving in more refined steps, 0.1 meter. And now I can simply release my mouse before I release control shift, and now it's perfectly positioned. And well, that's basically transformations. Let's start with rotations. I'll just click this button. And you can just do the same thing here. I'll just select one of these. Let's select the blue line. Left click and drag around the object. And it's rotating around Z in this case. I'll just hold down control. And it's rotating in steps of 5 degrees. Control shift. It's rotating in steps of 1 degree. So I release the mouse and then it's positioned. Now for scale, the same thing once again. Let me just press Ctrl Z first, undo. It's moving back like it was on the top here, edit. You can see undo is Ctrl Z, redo is Shift Ctrl Z. So let's move to scale. And in this case, I could select one of these axes again. But let's just take a look at these squares. If you select the move button, you've got these squares as well. So let's scale, selecting this square, for instance. And now it's scaling across two directions, X and Y. And not in the Z direction. Again, Control Shift also works, of course. So that's basically transformations. But I use keys. Let me just press Ctrl Z once again and move back to the select box here and now use keys. Anyway, I press G for grab. It's moving. So for the direction, you can just do several things. You can just hold down middle mouse and you can just move and select, well, you can see it, the axis is highlighted at this point, and you can just select a direction like Z, Y or X, and then I can release the middle mouse and it's moving into the X direction in this point. Now again I can hold out Control or Control Shift, of course, and I can also press keys like Z, for instance. It's moving up and down. Y, moving along the y-axis, but you can just also use the middle mouse just to select a direction. So that's both an option. Now if I hold down control and putting it at 4 meters, for instance, I can just right click to cancel this, and let me press G again along X, control 4 meters, and left click to confirm. Let's just rotate. I press R. And now you can do the same thing. Just middle click and you can select X, Y or Z. And then I just release the middle mouse and now it's rotating around X. Like that. Or just press keys like Z, for instance. Now I'm going to right click to cancel this. And let's try scale. S, not scaling in every direction. Now you could press, for instance, Z, it's scaling in the Z direction, but you could also press Shift Z, and now it's scaling in not the Z direction, so across the floor basically along X and Y. Or hold down Shift and then middle click and select a direction with the mouse, the Y, the Z, and the X. You can type in stuff as well. If I press G for movement and just middle click like this, I could say, for instance, four. I'll type in four in the top of the keyboard. It's moving four to the right. I could also include a minus sign, minus, and it's moving to the left. And let's just press the minus sign once again. It's moving to the right once again. So that's another option. And then I could say 0.5, for instance. It's 4.5. You can see it in the top left between the brackets. Or minus. Yeah, that sort of thing. And I'll just left click to confirm or right click to cancel. Same goes with the rotations and scale. Yeah. So let's do something with this. And we're going to build a small house, a simple house, just to practice this all. So, top view, well, let's build a wall. Trump would love it. Let's scale, top view, Alt, middle click, drag up, scale, middle click, drag. And now it's in the Y direction. I'm going to type in 0.1, for instance, like this. Front view, I'm going to scale it along X, and I'm going to type in 5, for instance, 5 times, enter, or middle, or just left click, and scale Z, let's type in 2, something like that, and then G, move it upwards, hold down control, it's going to be here, and I've got myself a wall. Now I need to duplicate this wall. Well, object, here, duplicate object, it says Shift D. And there's no reason to have it Shift D. I just right click, change shortcut, and I'm just going to type in D. So now it's D instead of Shift D. So if I move to Edit Preferences, you can see an asterisk here. I'm just going to save these preferences. And now it's just D. So if I press D, it duplicated the wall. And it's instantly in grab mode as well. So I just middle click drag along Y, and let's hold down control and just put it 5 meters along Y, like this. Now I left click to confirm. And put a roof on top of it. I press D, duplicate, and right away I press R for rotate, hold on control, and 45 degrees, top left, you can see 45 degrees like this, then left click and then release control key. So G, middle click drag upwards, and I'm gonna put it, let's say, at 2.2 meters, something like this, and then G, I'm gonna move it 1.1 a little bit further, like this. Yeah, okay, let's do the same here. Duplicate D, I press R, hold down control, rotate 45, move upwards 2.2, G once again. Like that. Now they're not really together just yet, so I'm just going to scale it. I just press S for scale. I'm going to supply a direction like Z, for instance, and it's moving along Z. But if I press Z twice, it's in the Z direction relative to the rotation of the object itself. this works for any of these transformations as well. I'm holding down Control Shift. Let's say 1.04. Let's do the same here. Scale. Z. I press it twice. Control Shift. 1.04, like this. And now it's sealed up a bit in the top. Like so. Now for the other wall. Let's take a top view. Alt, middle click, drag. Duplicate. I'm in grab mode. I instantly press R. I'm gonna rotate it like this, 90 degrees, and then G, put it here. 4.8, I think. 4.9. Yeah, 4.9. Like that. Side view. So this is too big. Scale, middle click drag along Y, and then control like 0.48, like this. Control Shift 0.48, like so. And then duplicate top view. Let's say select the front view, duplicate. Hold down Control, and I'm just going to put it here, 9.8 meters to this direction. So we have got two walls. Now the only gap we have to fill is this one. But, well, let's try. Side view. I press D, duplicate, R, rotate, 45 degrees. But as you can see, it's not a perfect rectangle. It's a rectangle. It's not a perfect square. I can fill it up like this, but I have a problem with that. Now, there's another key regarding transformations. I'm just gonna reset the scale to its original value. So Alt S. That is resetting the scale to its original values. It's a cube again. Alt R, for instance, rotation. It's resetting the rotation as well. Alt G. Is putting it back to the center. So I'm just going to press Ctrl Z a couple of times, like this. So now I'm going to just going to scale it. Middle click drag along X. 0.1. I'm just going to type it in 0.1. Now it's the same size as the wall. Side view. I'm going to move it upwards like this. And now I'm going to scale it. Scale 1.8. I hold down Control, left click, and then it's there. Something like this. That looks good. Oh, I scaled in the X direction as well. Let's do that again. Control Z, scale, and now I'm going to type in Shift X. As you can see, these lines are highlighted. It only scales in the Z and the Y direction. Now I'm just going to Control Shift. 1.8, I think. Control 1.8, like this. Left click, and now the thickness of the wall is the same. So that's basically it. Top view, alt middle click, drag. D, duplicate, middle click, and drag. It's already in grab mode, so Control Shift, move it over here. 9.8 meters, like that, and they are both done. So this is a basic house. And I would like to have a chimney. And I could just say, this one for instance, I just duplicate and then Alt S, reset the scale, like this. Alt G, reset the position, like this. But I can also just add a new cube. I'm just going to press X, delete this one. And as you can see here, there's an add menu here. If I hover across it, it says Shift A. So you can just use this menu, add, and there's a lot of things you can do here, but let's move to mesh. That's basic shapes, right? And let's select cube. There it is. So you can also use Shift A. I like to use key, so I use Shift A. And then I'm gonna scale it. in Shift Z, I hold down Shift, middle click drag upwards, for instance, like this, and then I'm going to type in 0.5. So that's going to be the chimney side view, and I'm going to move it over here somewhere, let's say someplace, and then scale in the Z direction. Let's say something like this, 2.5 or so. That's great. And that's the chimney. I suggest you try this a couple of times, preferably, just to get a hang of it, to work these transformations, because you're going to be using them a lot. Now we could save this from to File. Open recent. Let's save as house. It's already there, so it's turned red. Let's just remove that for the moment. File. Save as. Now it's gone. So I'll just type in here house, and it's not red, so I can just save it. Next video will be about, I think, extrusions. That's a very interesting topic. And we're going to edit or design some real stuff. So, if you found this video any useful, then click like, and click subscribe if you just like to see more of these videos in the future. Thanks for watching. See you all later.